Hello everyone, this will be the review of game ToaZZle, and the key was provided by developer. The game has broken shortcut on the desktop because it has one Z and not two, and it doesn't react. You have to start the game from Steam, just from your library. Also, when it comes to options, it has broken full screen. It doesn't work, it just cuts the entire it cuts the game, but it cannot go back to game. It just cut and doesn't react. It's very, very, very broken. Also, two languages, nothing special, Russian and English. The music is also broken because it stays like this, even when it looks like this. Every time you go out of game, the music is switched off. It stays like this and it still plays. You have to go on and off to make it work. So this is problematic, but the game itself works. The game itself is about a frog that jumps over other frogs. I'm gonna show it to you like this. You jump, and you jump. And that's the game. Quite loud effects that can be on and off. I would like to have a slider and, generally speaking, working resolution, working full screen, and working sliders for music and sound, which is all broken. But the game itself is not broken. The game itself works proper. Let's try to beat the other level, or not. Maybe not. Like this? No. I'm stuck. So, if you want a hint, one hint is one move. You have to pay 10 flies. You get 100 at the beginning for just getting the game. And then you earn a little bit after you beat levels. There is 40 levels overall. So I'm gonna show you. Yeah, 40 levels. So this is another example of a puzzle game which has one idea, 13 places. Like this, with frogs on them or not on them. And all the iterations of this one puzzle, all the versions. And you try to beat it, or you get stuck, and then you reset, or you buy all the hints. So that's the whole game. Can I recommend it? It should be fixed, definitely, because pretty much the entire option section is broken. Nothing works as it should, but the game itself does work, only on this full screen version, but it does work, it doesn't crash. It has even broken shortcut, so this is unacceptable. However, yeah, the game is just like other games I was showing you before. It's always the same idea. It's a puzzle that has one idea and many, many levels that are increased in difficulty or at least in length. And you have to beat all of them to finish the game, or maybe to just have satisfaction, because really, I don't know if there is any end game really to those games. You just beat every or some of the challenges, or you get stuck, or you can try any level, depends. And that's it. That's one puzzle in digital form, working properly. You know, it's reactive. You know, you click something and it shows you the result. That's all it does, which is okay. And you don't expect more from those games. They're very little content. They are basically a part of some sort of mind-bending big book of puzzles, we could say. If you just connect all of them, all of those games into one, there will be just one big game that just has tons of puzzles for you to solve, which is okay. I'm always for stuff like that. It should be there. It should exist in digital form. Why not? But the the quantity is not big, really. It's just one puzzle, to be honest. I get it. It's more complicated, but it's just one puzzle. So the question is, how much would you pay for one puzzle digital? It's not something you do on paper. It's something you do with your mouse and screen, but still it's just one puzzle. And puzzles like this are usually for free on the internet. If you just want to try some stuff to, you know, make some brain gymnastics, you can do it, usually for free. You can just, you know, download any Mensa test and do it, and pretty much the same result. But yeah, we have it in digitalized form. It can be used by kids, it can be used by people who want to train for some IQ tests. Yeah, I'm supporting it. Just be aware that this is just one thing. I just have to kill my phone because it's calling me all the time. And we'll be finishing the review here. So I would give it 5 out of 10 because this is basically doing what it's supposed to do, but it's nothing really specific, not really awesome as a game, but it's okay as a puzzle. It does what it's supposed to do and does it in a way that doesn't annoy you. However, I would fix all the settings and options because they shouldn't be broken like this. So that will be it from me. I'll see you guys in the next review.